comprehensive guide to recurrent dislocation of patella. The video is created by Dr. Abhinav Gupta and team. In this video, we have covered everything about the topic from initiation to the end. Recurrent dislocation of the patella refers to a condition where the kneecap, patella, repeatedly slips out of its normal position within the groove of the femur, often causing pain, instability, and functional impairment. Predisposing factors for recurrent dislocation of patella. 1. Anatomical factors. Shallow trochlear groove. A shallow or dysplastic groove in the femur can make it easier for the patella to dislocate. Patella alta, high riding patella, an elevated position of the patella relative to the trochlear groove. 2. Muscle imbalances. Weakness of quadriceps muscles. Insufficient strength in the quadriceps muscles can contribute to poor patella stability. Imbalance in muscle pull. An imbalance between the inner and outer quadriceps muscles may influence patella tracking. 3. Soft tissue laxity. Generalized ligamentous laxity, increased joint laxity, often associated with hypermobility syndromes, can contribute to patellar instability. 4. Joint dysplasia. Femoral or tibial dysplasia. Abnormal development of the femur or tibia can affect the alignment of the patella. 5. Previous trauma or injuries. Patella fractures or dislocations. Previous incidents of patella injuries can contribute to recurrent dislocation. 6. Malalignment of lower limb. Valgus, knock knee, or varus, bow leg, alignment. Abnormal alignment of the lower limb can impact patella tracking. 7. Foot pronation. Flat feet or overpronation. Abnormal foot mechanics can influence the alignment of the entire lower extremity, affecting the patella. 8. Muscle tightness. Tightness in lateral retinaculum. Tightness in the lateral structures of the knee can contribute to lateral patella displacement. 9. Traumatic events. Direct trauma to the patella, a significant blow or impact to the front of the knee may result in recurrent dislocation. 10. Genetic factors. Family history. There may be a genetic predisposition to patella instability. Clinical features of recurrent dislocation of patella. 1. Pain. Patients often experience pain during and after episodes of patella dislocation. 2. Swelling. Swelling around the kneecap area may occur following dislocation events. 3. Visible dislocation. The patella may visibly move out of its normal position during certain activities. 4. Instability. A feeling of instability or giving way in the knee, especially during weight-bearing activities. 5. Crepitus. Audible or palpable grinding or popping sensations during joint movement. 6. Limited range of motion. Restriction in the normal range of motion of the knee. Radiograph for recurrent dislocation of patella. X-rays may be used to assess the alignment of the patella and the overall structure of the knee joint. Specific views, such as the lateral view, are often utilized to evaluate patella tracking and any associated structural abnormalities. Blumenthal line. The Blumenthal line is a reference line on a lateral knee radiograph. It is drawn along the roof of the intercondylar notch and is used to assess the inclination of the patellar tendon. Deviation from this line may indicate abnormalities in the patellofemoral joint. Non-surgical treatment other than physiotherapy. 1. Bracing. Utilizing knee braces to provide additional support and stabilize the patella. 2. Orthotics. Custom orthotic devices to correct foot mechanics and lower limb alignment. 3. Activity modification. Avoiding activities that may trigger patella dislocation. 4. Patella taping. Application of tape to guide patella tracking during movement. 5. Medications. Non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, NSAIDs, for pain and inflammation management. Surgical treatment for recurrent dislocation of patella. 1. Medial patellofemoral ligament, MPFL, reconstruction. Surgical reconstruction of the MPFL, a ligament crucial for patella stability. 2. Lateral release. Surgical release of tight lateral structures to balance patella tracking. 3. Tibial tubercle osteotomy. Repositioning of the tibial tubercle to alter the forces acting on the patella. 4. Trochleoplasty. Surgical modification of the trochlear groove to improve patella tracking. 5. Rehabilitation protocols. Post-surgical physiotherapy to regain strength, range of motion, and optimize patella stability. The choice between surgical and non-surgical approaches depends on factors such as the severity of the condition, the underlying anatomical issues, and the patient's overall health. Decisions should be made in consultation with an orthopedic specialist based on a thorough evaluation. Week-wise physiotherapy management for recurrent dislocation of patella. Weeks 1 to 2, acute phase. 1. Pain management. Modalities such as ice therapy and elevation to reduce pain and swelling. 2. Range of motion, roam, exercises. Gentle passive and active assisted knee range of motion exercises to prevent stiffness. 3. Quadriceps activation. Isometric quadriceps contractions to maintain muscle tone without putting excessive stress on the knee. Weeks 3 to 6. Transition to active phase. 1. Progressive weight bearing. Gradual introduction of weight bearing activities under supervision. 2. Strengthening exercises. Initiation of quadriceps and hamstring strengthening exercises, focusing on concentric and eccentric muscle contractions. 3. Patella stabilization exercises. Incorporating exercises to enhance patella stability, such as terminal knee extension and patella tracking exercises. Weeks 7 to 12, intermediate phase. 1. Functional activities. Integration of functional activities and exercises simulating real-life movements. 2. Balance and proprioception training. Exercises to improve balance and proprioception to enhance joint awareness and stability. 3. Cardiovascular conditioning. Low-impact cardiovascular exercises, such as stationary cycling or swimming, to improve overall fitness. Weeks 13 to 24, advanced strengthening and functional rehabilitation. 1. Advanced strengthening exercises. Progression to more advanced strength training exercises, including lunges and step-ups. 2. Sport-specific training. Sport-specific drills and exercises tailored to the patient's activities and demands. 3. Plyometrics. Gradual introduction of plyometric exercises to improve explosive strength and dynamic stability. Beyond week 24, maintenance and injury prevention. 1. Maintenance program. Development of a personalized home exercise program to maintain strength, flexibility, and joint stability. 2. Regular monitoring. Periodic follow-up appointments with the physiotherapist to monitor progress and address any emerging issues. 3. Education on injury prevention. Instruction on proper warm-up, cool-down, and techniques to prevent recurrent injuries.